Good morning, y'all. This is A. Renee from Journal Jot and Jive. Thank you all for stopping by the channel. If this is your first time, welcome to the channel. Get comfy, have a seat, take out your planner or your journals, and stay around for the ride. If you're returning, hey, y'all. All right, y'all. So we're going to be talking about Happynichi, Fauxbonichi, Hobonichi, all the nichis, right? So a couple of y'all probably want to know, what's the difference? Which one is which? Which one should I use? Okay, so first answer to which one should you use, whatever you're more comfortable with and whatever you're going to be the most productive with, okay? Now, if you use planners for hobbies, hey, by all means, do whatever you want to do. I do use both, and I'm going to explain how I use both, all right? So now this right here is the half notes, or the notes, the happy notes, and most people are now referring to them as the Happynichi or the Fauxbonichi. All right, the first time that I saw something like this, y'all, was by At Home with Quita. She actually repurposed, cut her planner in half, laminated, and created this with the half sheets. I thought it was the dopest thing. I have actually liked half sheets for quite some time. I started preferring them over the classic size. So the half sheets work really, really well. I use them in reference to daily sheets, just keeping lists. I repurpose my sheets. So I would say that I'm more of a Happynichi planner in reference to this size, okay? When you refer to Fauxbonichi, I look at Fauxbonichi as recreating what the Hobonichi looks like, but you get a little more space. I don't recreate the Hobonichi because I have a Hobonichi, so I don't feel like doing all of that. That's just not gonna work for me. However, if that's what you do, that's awesome, that's great. There is no wrong or right reason, okay, y'all? I know a lot of times you can get overwhelmed in this community. You wanna recreate what you see, and you go out and you buy all this stuff, but if it does not work for you, guess what? That is okay. Toss it to the side, donate it, and keep it moving, all right? So I think, let me show you the Hobonichi first, okay? Because this is where a little bit of that craze came from. This actually was gifted to me, and I use both. Again, I use this for a self-care planner. Now, what you have, I'm not gonna break down the whole Hobonichi life. I think I have a video somewhere on here, in here. I may link that at the top, I may not, I don't know, y'all. All right, so you get monthly views. This was, I got mine to start in April, so I was just playing around with this. And sometimes I don't even use the whole monthly view. I've never really been a major monthly planner unless I'm in my plum planner for bills. So outside of that, I haven't been using it as much, but I did get a kit. This kit is by Gold Mine and Coco. The doll is sold separately. And so this takes us into May. So currently I'm just tracking my weight, Mother's Day, and a fitness program. And then I did mention when my gym bill is due. And then you get this part right there, okay? So a lot of people will recreate this in their Fauxbonichi. I'm gonna say Fauxbonichi is your sister to your Hobonichi. Your Happynichi is whatever you want it to be. And I'll show you how I use mine as a Happynichi. All right, and then you go in here, and I'll show you a blank sheet. This is what the blank layout looks like. You have your weekly on one side and you have a blank side to do whatever you want to do with it. Again, I turned mine into a self-care planner. So this is all about me, things that I have to do if I'm going out somewhere, if I'm taking care of myself, but this is all about A. Renee, or you'll hear me say Adrian, that's my name. So if you hear A. Renee or Adrian, it's one and the same. So this is all about me. So you have this, and I just write things that I've done for myself. I track my mood in here. I'm not always consistent. If it happens, it does. If it doesn't, life goes on. Okay, y'all, don't let the planner hold you hostage. Let the planner help you. If it didn't help you on that way, on that week, life goes on. All right. So again, this is just all about self-care. Sometimes I'll write a journal moment in there, and then sometimes it just didn't happen. Again, don't allow the planner to hold you hostage. And then we, again, all about self-care. I didn't finish tracking. And then this is this current week right here, okay? So this is how I use my Hobonichi. You also have a section in the back where you can use for journal moments, and I do use journal moments, or I list different things that I want to do. So this is, again, how I use my Hobonichi. Sometimes I set up pages, and when I'm ready to write on those pages, I will do so. So that is the Hobonichi. All right. So again, remember, I do not use my notes as a Fauxbonichi because I'm just not going to do it. That's just too redundant for me. And I don't have time for that. So I like to call this my Happynichi. I want to say this. If it's not making you happy, then let it go. L-I-G. I will always say let it go. All right. So I'm going to open mine up. This was also gifted to me. Y'all, like, planner sisters and planner friends are the bomb. I was actually on a no spin and she sent me like a packet full of everything. So it took me a while to even start using this because I was like, I don't know how I want to use it. So what I ended up doing was pulling a variety of half sheets. Some sheets have been out for a while. Some sheets are new. These came inside of this. And then I just, again, pulled some regular sheets that I already had. And I repurposed my sheets. So I'm going to show you how I do that. So again, I'm allowing this to serve as my Happynichi. I created this last night. This is actually going to be today's sheet. I put two adhesive pockets in here. I have this is a memo pad, notepad, sticky pad, whatever you want to call it. And then I just put little notes on there whenever I feel like writing it. And then I have some die cuts in there. This was actually, let's see if I have an extra sheet in here. This is actually like the memory keeping sheet. And this is what this sheet looks like before. Okay, so this sheet looks just like this. And then I decided to layer it and put some different things on there and then start putting the things that I'll be doing for the day. I am typically what you would call a daily sheet planner. I like to see what I have going on in front of me for the day. I do plan for the week, but I do that as an overall assessment in case I don't want to pick up the planner at all. But for the most part, daily planning makes me happy. So as you see, I have no particular order in here with these sheets because I use them how I want to. Whatever I'm feeling for that day, I will use. There are some days where I will do all pen, no stickers. I'll color code with highlighters. So that is why, again, I'm referring to this as my Happynichi. It makes me happy and I'm gonna do what I want with it, okay? So again, you wanna have fun and be productive with your sheet, all right? So again, this is gonna be for today, but let me go ahead and show you some other sheets. Now on the back, I am gonna do some other things with this sheet. I'm not going to do a decorate with me or a plan with me for this video. This is mainly for the purpose of just explaining the differences between the two or three. I say three because we name it two different things, and then the Hobonichi. This was actually my first week just trying this out. I was on a video on here and somebody asked how could they do a weekly recap in a happy planner or happy planner items, because I typically do this in a journal. So I showed them how to use this sheet. And then when you flip over, this is actually for this week. So this is a weekly overview. If I didn't do anything else for the week, this already told me everything that I pretty much need to do. There may be one or two things outside of that, and then that's it, all right? And then we flip over, and this was May 13th, and then I did a journal moment on there, and then I didn't do anything on the back of this. So what I'll probably do is do a brain dump for the upcoming week just so I didn't waste this page. And then this was yesterday. So again, this was another sheet from a totally different pack. I added a couple of stickers on here, highlighted to break it down in sections. And that was my daily sheet. And then there's nothing on the back right now, so I can repurpose this and create this for another day, all right? So again, I use mine as a Happynichi. You put in whatever pages you want. If you went through a stage like I did and every time you saw a half pack, you picked it up, put those half pack sheets in here, put a variety and make it work. Now, if you were doing the Fauxbonichi, most people are going to use the dot grid to create. And you're just going to create those seven lines and then you keep this and you use all the different stickers, like shop your stash, y'all. Use your sticker books, use your stickers you buy from small sticker shops. And stop hoarding, right? It's cool to buy, but you want to use, make room for more. So that's all I wanted to come on and show you all today. I know y'all are used to me putting some stuff together. I don't know, I'll do one of those another day. But I did want to give a breakdown on what is the difference between them. Should you get it? Should you not? The only major advice that I would say is buy with the intent to use and use it wisely. Don't do the whole FOMO, fear of missing out, because that can set you back financially, and then later down the line you're kind of upset with yourself. So that is not the goal. We want to also make sure that we keep our mental health intact. It is Mental Health Awareness Month, so these all correlate, okay? Don't overspend to deal with other stuff. Make sure you're planning for productivity, and make sure you all have an amazing day. If you made it to the end of the video and you think this is a channel you're gonna like and you're new, make sure you hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so every time I post, you are in the know. Have an amazing day.